ladies and gentlemen, from along the banks of the beautiful Boise River in Idaho's capital city, I'm Claudia Weatherman, joining you live from the Morrison Center for Performing Arts for the telecast of the 40th annual Miss Idaho Scholarship Pageant. 15 beautiful and talented young ladies have come from throughout the Gem State to vie for the title of Miss Idaho 1989. And one of them will travel to Atlantic City this September to vie for the Miss America crown. KIVI Channel 6 and tonight's sponsors are proud to present to you now 1989 Miss Idaho Pageant.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, from the beautiful Morrison Center for the Performing Arts on the campus of Boise State University, this is the 1989 Miss Idaho Pageant.
Well, there's no reason to believe she'd always be there. But if you don't put faith in what you believe in, that's getting you nowhere. Cause it helps you never give up. Don't look down, just look up.
Celebration of the Miss Idaho Pageant, starring these 15 beautiful and talented Idaho women. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Idaho 1988, Susan K. Hart. And your host for tonight's pageant, first runner-up to Miss America 1988, from Dallas, Texas, Patricia Brandt Tozen.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's wonderful to be here in Idaho's capital city for this, the 40th annual Miss Idaho Scholarship Pageant. We welcome you here in the Morrison Center and those joining us by television. The road to Atlantic City has already begun for each of these beautiful young ladies. And before this evening has come to an end, one of these 15 contestants will have her dream come true. Who will become Miss Idaho 1989? Let's meet them now.
I'm Miss Boise Melanie Jean Lavoie, and my pageant is held right here in Boise.
Smith, and my pageant is held in Preston.
Hi, I'm Miss Idaho National Guard, Amy Lynn Kendall, and my pageant's held right here in Boise.
I'm Miss Meridian Pamela Westover, and my pageant is held in Meridian.
I'm Miss Washington County Rebecca Jo Fetcher, and my pageant is held in Weezer.
I'm Miss Idaho Falls, Jerry Lynn Somers, and my pageant is held in Idaho Falls.
Miss Northside Magic Valley, Lori Mae Beers, and my pageant is held in Jerome.
I'm Miss Winnecash and Nicole Goodwin, and my pageant was held in Early.
I'm Miss Gem County, Darnell Lynn Miller, and my pageant is held in Emmett.
I'm Miss Rexburg Upper Valley, Raven Jean Griffith, and my pageant is held in Rexburg.
Hi, my name is Melissa Ann Matthews, Miss Fair Lake, and my pageant is held in Montpelier.
Pocatello.
Hi, Miss Treasure Valley, Rebecca Eileen Trueblood, and my pageant was held in Caldwell.
And there they are, ladies and gentlemen, the 15 state finalists for the crown of Miss Idaho 1989. In just a few minutes, we will learn the identities of the 8 young ladies who have been selected as semi-finalists in tonight's program of finals. All 15 contestants competed last night in the preliminary competition in swimsuit, talent, and evening gown. Earlier this week, each contestant also had a personal interview with the distinguished judges. But first, before our semifinalists are announced, let us meet again the young lady from Rigby, Idaho, who came to this pageant last year as Miss Idaho Falls. Ladies and gentlemen, the lovely Susan K. Hart, Miss Idaho 1988. We're
so glad you've joined us for this live telecast of the 40th annual Miss Idaho Scholarship Pageant. We'll be back in a moment with the exciting announcement of the top 8 semifinalists. But first, a word from our sponsors. Let's go back to the Morrison Center stage with Patricia Brandt Tozen, tonight's host.
Thank you. You have all met the 15 contestants, each of whom has been scored individually and has competed only with herself. Each contestant was scored from 1 to 10 after finishing her individual competition. The talent competition this year counts 40%, the personal interview is 30%, the evening gown and swimsuit competitions are 15% each. May I have the envelope, please? Our 8 semifinalists are those who have accumulated the greatest number of points. And the top 8 semifinalists in performing order are contestant number 1, Melanie Jean Lavoie, Miss Boise. Contestant number two, Stephanie Ann Smith, Miss Eastern Idaho. Contestant number six, Pamela Westover, Miss Meridian. Contestant number eight, Darity Lynn Summers, Miss Idaho Falls. Contestant number five, Amy Lynn Kendall, Miss Idaho National Guard. Contestant number 12, Raymond Jean Griffith, Miss Rexburg Open Valley. Contestant number 14, Alicia Lynn Allman, Miss Pocatello. And contestant number 15, Rebecca Eileen. Semifinalists for tonight's competition and the crown of Miss Idaho 1989. Well, you have met the eight semifinalists a moment ago, and you were told about all the points that they had added up. Beginning now, the judges will put aside those points and will begin anew. Not even the judges will know the name of Miss Idaho 1989 until tonight's balloting is completed at the end of this live telecast. And as you may have noticed, I brought a friend all the way from Louisiana, Gumbo Gator. Hi, yo. So Gumbo is going to help me meet the individuals who from across the country have given so much of their time and personal effort to help the Miss Idaho pageant. We'll begin with our first judge, Miss Sharon Monroe. She's the executive director of the Miss Nevada pageant, and she owns her own modeling agency. Woo! Good looking lady. Come on, Sharon, stand up there. Who's next, Gumbo? We got old Jack Collins. Yes, Jack Collins. He's in his 10th year as the executive director of the Miss Illinois pageant. Please welcome Jack Collins. Woo! And next we have Renee Shinney Nelson. She is the lifestyle editor of the Daily Herald in Provo, Utah. Please welcome Mrs. Renee Nelson. I like those good-looking judges. And next we have Dave Woodard. He's the executive director of the Miss Wichita pageant, which is Kansas's largest local pageant. Please welcome Dave Woodard.
Yeah, there he is.
Good, we've got another good-looking lady next.
Yes, we do. Ms. Marla Good, an executive administrative assistant with Baxter Healthcare Corporation of Illinois. She's also a state field director for the Miss Illinois pageant. Ms. Marla Good. Woo! All of our ballots will be tallied by the Boise firm of Belukoff, Lindstrom, and Company. So please welcome Kathy Jones and Val Burton. Boy, thanks, Gumbo, for all your help introducing our wonderful judges and the auditors. But you know what? We have a special guest with us this evening. He's in our audience, and he's representing the Honorable Cecil D. Andrus, the governor of Idaho. He is Senator Mike Burkett from Ada County. Senator?
Yeah, there he is.
You've met Gumbo, but he's just one of Patricia's friends. Now here's two more of her friends she's brought all the way from the bayous of Louisiana, Cooper and Katie. They'll be performing the number that captured a talent award at the Miss America pageant in Atlantic City.
Thank you.
Hey, guys. All right, now we're going to start with my favorite song. Ready? One, two, three, four. Row, row, row your boat. Row, gently row down, row the street, your boat. Merrily, gently, merrily down the merrily stream. Merrily, nearly life, nearly is but nearly a dream. Nearly lying, row is the row a dream. Row, you're the row. Gently row down, row the street, your boat. Nearly, gently, nearly down the nearly stream. Nearly, nearly life, nearly is but nearly a dream. Nearly lying is the a dream. Well, that was pretty good, you two. Now let's tell everyone that story about how the two of you met. It's so romantic.
Oh, brother.
Way out in Arizona, in a town they call Winona, where the folks you meet all know a thing or two.
Yeah, boy.
Lived a lad of great ambition who had set it his life's mission. Could sell upon his yodeler.
Play a little tune on his Spanish guitar. He'd mingle with his song of sweet refrain.
Well, that was pretty good, Cooper.
Oh, shucks, Trish.
Why don't you tell everybody? How'd you learn to yodel so good?
Well, in the evening in the cactus, I would get a lot of practice with my yodel. As my cattle are trailing, you'd always hear me wailing on my yodeling.
Soon he met a little maiden who was talented to us laden, and she fell for him like flowers for the dew.
Oh.
And he wished not to evade her, so he used to serenade her with his yodeling.
Play a little tune on his Spanish guitar. He mingle with his song a sweet refrain.
Thank you, Cooper and Katie, and not to mention Patricia. We'll get back to the Idaho Miss Idaho pageant after this word from our sponsors. Semifinalists have already been announced. Now back to the Morrison Center stage for the swimsuit competition.
Beginning now, live, you and the judges will see a brand new competition in our program of finals. The 8 semifinalists for the crown of Miss Idaho 1989 in 3 separate categories: swimsuit, talent, and evening gown. Ladies and gentlemen, our 8 semifinalists in swimsuit competition. Beginning with contestant number 1, Miss Boise, Melanie Jean Lavoie. Melanie is a graduate of West Boylston Junior Senior High School and Becker Junior College, both in Massachusetts. And she is currently a junior at Boise State University, majoring in business administration. A member of the National Honor Society in high school and a Dean's List scholar in college, Melanie is working towards a Bachelor of Science degree in Business Administration, along with a minor in Marketing. Our first contestant will sing Cornet Man from the Broadway musical Funny Girl for her talent performance. Contestant number one, Melanie Jean Lavoie, Miss Boise. Contestant number two, Miss Eastern Idaho, Stephanie Ann Smith. A 1989 graduate in marketing from Boise State University, Stephanie plans to use her education to own and operate her own business in Idaho's Treasure Valley. Miss Eastern Idaho also desires to take additional classes in music theory and to become fluent in a second language. Stephanie's also a graduate of the Dale Carnegie Public Speaking School. After 13 years of private harp lessons, we will be given the opportunity to hear Stephanie play the harp for her talent presentation. Contestant number two, Stephanie Ann Smith, Miss Eastern Idaho. Contestant number six, Miss Meridian, Pamela Westover. Seeking a Bachelor of Arts degree in marketing at Boise State University, Pamela would like to pursue a career that allows her to combine leadership skills and creativity in the advertising field. In 1986 at BSU, Miss Meridian was a homecoming princess. And in 1987, she served as BSU Student Ambassador. A student of voice for 4 years, tonight Pamela sings Alan J. Lerner and Burton Lane's What Did I Have That I Don't Have? For her talent presentation. Contestant number six, Pamela Westover, Miss Meridian. Contestant number eight, Miss Idaho Falls, Darity Lynn Somers. A graduate of Skyline High School, Miss Idaho Falls is in her second year at Ricks College in Rexburg, where she is a secondary education major, focusing on U.S. history. Darity hopes to obtain a bachelor's degree in U.S. history and English so she can teach in the high school. Darity earned a piano scholarship for 11 consecutive superior ratings in the Junior Music Festival. Miss Idaho Falls will play Paderewski's Minuet in G for tonight's talent competition. Contestant number eight, Darity Lynn Somers, Miss Idaho Falls. Contestant number five, Miss Idaho National Guard, Amy Lynn Kendall. Amy is a graduate of American Falls High School, and she's in her second year at Rexburg's Ricks College. Miss Idaho National Guard hopes to someday become a school guidance counselor. That is after receiving her bachelor and master's degrees. Amy was recognized in Who's Who in American High School Students, and at Ricks was a member of the Concert Chorale. This evening, Miss Idaho National Guard will sing the Sandy Patty style, Amazing Grace. Contestant number five, Amy Lynn Kendall, Miss Idaho National Guard. Contestant number 12, Miss Rexburg Upper Valley, Rayma Jean Griffith. Rayma Jean is a graduate of Madison High School, and she's a junior at Ricks College, where she's majoring in secondary education and health science. Miss Rexburg Upper Valley selected this field because she enjoys teaching older students, and she said she has a deep appreciation for health and anatomy. A Girl State delegate in high school, Rayma Jean traveled throughout Europe with an American folk dance team. To the Overture of Oklahoma, Miss Rexburg Upper Valley will perform a character ballet on point for her talent presentation this evening. Contestant number 12, Rayma Jean Griffith, Miss Rexburg Upper Valley. Contestant number 14, Miss Pocatello, Alicia Lynn Allman. A graduate of Snake River High School, Alicia attended Utah Valley Community College with a major in psychology. She hopes to someday obtain a master's degree in psychology also. A winner of many awards in high school, Ms. Pocatello has received a fully paid academic and Leadership Scholarship to Brigham Young University. Tonight, Alicia's talent performance will be Franz Liszt's Hungarian Rhapsody at the piano. Contestant number 14, Alicia Lynn Almond, Miss Pocatello. Contestant number 15, Miss Treasure Valley, Rebecca Eileen Trueblood. Becky is a graduate of Valley View High School and attended Northwest Nazarene College. She's currently a Communications Behavioral Studies student at Boise State University. Miss Treasure Valley's future goals revolve around her abilities as a strong communicator. She believes that an in-depth study of communications and human behavior will allow her to reach her goal with success. In high school, Becky was a member of the National Honor Society and student body president at NNC, freshman class sweetheart. Miss Treasure Valley sings a vocal ballad by Michael O'Brien tonight entitled Changing. Contestant number 15, Rebecca Eileen Trueblood, Miss Treasure Valley. Ladies and gentlemen, our beautiful semifinalists in swimsuit competition. And now, while our eight semifinalists prepare for the all-important talent competition, it is my pleasure to visit with Idaho's representative to the 1988 Miss America pageant in Atlantic City. Please welcome Miss Idaho 1988, Susan K. Hart. Hi. Boy, we sure know what these contestants are going through right now, don't we?
We do. I remember at this time last year, I was extremely excited but extremely nervous.
Yeah, it's kind of the two mixed together, isn't it?
Yes.
Right here on live television, too.
That's the most exciting part.
Yeah, you found that out in Atlantic City,
yes.
Didn't you? Well, tell us, what have been some of your highlights for this year? I know you've been able to have a fun-filled year that's been very full. Tell us a little bit.
My year started out during the summer. I traveled to the local pageants throughout the state, and that was a wonderful part because there I met each contestant for the very first time. And then now as I meet the contestants again when we came together this week, I can't believe the changes that each young woman has made. They have improved so much, and they've grown. And the highlight, of course, of being Miss Idaho is going back to Atlantic City. And also, after Atlantic City, I was able to go to Disneyland, and that was a vacation to serve an Idaho day that they have, and it was wonderful.
A well-deserved vacation after all the hard work for Atlantic City, wasn't it?
Yes.
So tell us, what are your plans now? I know as your year as Miss Idaho, you've had a lot of supporters and friends and family that kind of feel like they own a little part of you now, and so they want to know, what's next? What are in your future plans?
Well, my future involves college, of course, and this spring I went to Boise State University, and there I decided on my major. And I'm going to major in communications and minor in dance. I will also go back to Ricks College because I want to receive my associate's degree. I went there my first year in 1987, and I couldn't feel complete without going back and receiving my degree. So I will start Ricks College again.
Oh, I know that makes everyone so proud. Susan, I know we're proud of you and the wonderful way that you served as Miss Idaho 1988. And we all look forward to seeing your Miss America performance later, don't we? We get a chance to see that for all of you that, shame on you, happened to miss her on TV. The Idaho wishes you the very best in all the years to come. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Idaho 1988, Susan K. Hart.
Isn't Miss Idaho a beautiful lady? And she's represented us so well this past year. We'll return in just a moment with the talent competition for our eight semifinalists and Susan Hart's Miss America performance right after this commercial message. The 40th anniversary of the Miss Idaho pageant continues now as the competition intensifies with the talent competition. Good luck, semifinalists.
The Miss America pageant is a scholarship pageant which encourages young women to develop their talents. Our 8 semifinalists perform individually in this competition, which, remember, counts for 40% of the total scores this evening. We're ready now for the talent competition. We'll begin with contestant number 1. Though many people are familiar with the movie Funny Girl, only few are aware that much of the music from the original Broadway score was omitted for the movie, starring Barbara Streisand as Fanny Bryce. Cornet Man was one of those songs, and we'll think that you agree with our first contestant that this song should have never been cut out. Please welcome contestant number 1, Melanie Jean Lavoie, Miss Boise.
I just put the kids to sleep and swept the shack. Took my sweet man's satchel down and watched him pack. I said, darling, while the stove still smolders, unpin your woman's hair and rub her shoulders. I threw myself across the doorway, begging, stay, sweet man, stay. But there's more in my man's life than this old hag. It's Jelly Roll Morton and a shiny cornet. And jazz in the rag. The lady ain't been born who can take the place of the horn with the cornet man. A going where there's blowing, traveling cornet man. Just any time they call him, he'll leave his wife and kitty sitting with their tongues out to play for peanuts in a dive and blow his lungs out. He'll hop a choo-choo on a moment's notice to play some dates with Billy Bates or Ragtime Otis. The lady ain't seen light, can't give a horn nothing.
Miss Eastern Idaho fell in love with the beautiful sounds of the harp. 2 years later, she began to make those sounds on her own harp. And tonight, Miss Eastern Idaho invites you to listen to a medley which includes the intricate sounds of the music box, the lullaby of Edelweiss, and the captivating rhythm of Great Day. Stephanie Ann Smith, Miss Eastern Idaho. Thank you. From the wonderful Broadway musical of a generation ago, On a Clear Day You Can See Forever, comes a great classic song. Pamela Westover sings now the penetrating and thought-provoked song, What Did I Have That I Don't Have? Ladies and gentlemen, Pamela Westover, Miss Meridian.
What did I do that I don't do the way I did before? What isn't there that once was there? What if I get a great big whack of something in me that he could see then beckons to him? Wouldn't I be the late, great me if I knew how? What did I have I don't have now? What did he like that I'm not like? What is that charm? What would I give if my guilt now how still knew how? What did I have that I don't have? What did he see that's gone now? What did I have I don't?
Pamela Westover, Miss Meridian. Darity Lynn Somers, Miss Idaho Falls, has expressed a strong personal magnetism. She said she loves to express that enthusiasm when performing on the piano, which she has studied for 13 years. So it's only natural that she play the externally familiar Minuet in G by Ignaz Paderewski. Darity expresses now her emotional and enthusiastic view of life with her favorite things: a brilliant red, a well-written musical composition, and a fine-tuned piano. Please welcome contestant number 8, Darity Lynn Somers, Miss Idaho Falls.
return to the Morrison Center in just a moment for the final four contestants in the talent competition right after this message.
Pretty good ventriloquist, huh? Didn't even see my lips move.
The excitement continues to build here at the Morrison Center with the last four semifinalists vying for the Miss Idaho crown in the talent competition. And what a talented group of young ladies we're seeing here this evening.
And we'll begin back with the talent portion of our competition with contestant number five. Her mother said that she came into this world singing. At the age of four, Miss Idaho National Guard had lungs that would put Ethel Merman to shame. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Amy Lynn Kendall with her heartfelt rendition of Amazing Grace. Revolutionized the musical. The style of ballet has also been revolutionized by Mikhail Baryshnikov. Watch now as Rayma Jean Griffith, Miss Rexburg Upper Valley, captures you with her interpretation of a character ballet on point to the Overture of Oklahoma. Contestant number 12, Rayma Jean Griffith, Miss Rexburg Upper Valley.
Thank you.
Alicia Lynn Almond's love of music at the piano started at a very young age as she sat with her father and listened to classical music. This appreciation grew through extensive training, and tonight she would like to dedicate Liszt's Hungarian Rhapsody to her father. She says it was one of his favorites. Here is Miss Pocatello, Alicia Lynn Almond. Eileen Trueblood, Miss Treasure Valley, has traveled extensively throughout the United States and over 20 foreign countries performing with a gospel music group. Her challenge, she said, is to make others feel what she is feeling through her music. Becky sings now an original song entitled Changing. Please welcome Miss Treasure Valley, Rebecca Eileen Trueblood.
Most important one was me.
to live my life away from you. Now I'm changing from the one that used to be. Oh Lord, I'm changing from the hope you've given me. Oh Lord, I'm changing. But with you, Lord, I'll walk instead. I'll walk instead. Lord, I'm changing from the one I used to be. Oh, Lord, I'm changing from the hope you've given me. Oh, Lord, I'm changing.
The 1989 Miss Idaho pageant is celebrating its 40th anniversary with the Boise Host Lions Club and is coming to you live from the Morrison Center in Idaho's capital city, Boise. Stay tuned now for the 8 semifinals in the evening gown competition, the 40th anniversary celebration, and a new Miss Idaho after this station break and a word from our sponsors. We're back at the Morrison Center stage to welcome again our talented reigning Miss Idaho 1988, Susan K. Hart.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you join me in welcoming Idaho's representative to the 1988 Miss America pageant with her Miss America talent performance, Don Quixote, Miss Idaho 1988, Susan K. Hart.
wonderful performance. You know, Susan told me earlier that her most memorable performance of that ballet was in Atlantic City. Susan's very tall, and the large stage allowed her to move so freely, it's something she'll never forget. Now let's go to Patricia and Cooper.
Cooper and I have had the wonderful opportunity to travel all over the country, and we're going to sing for you now a song that tells you a little bit about everywhere we've been. Well, I've been everywhere in land, I've been everywhere in land, across the desert there in land, and I've breathed the mountain there in land, travel I've had my share in land, I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Texas, Vegas, Arkansas, Hexark, Hattiesburg, Aldor, Sodor, Eureka, Niagara, Seneca, Alaska. I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert there, man, and I breathe the mountain air, man. Travel, I've had my share, man, I've been everywhere. I've been to Boston, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston, Texarkana, Monterey, Faraday, Santa Fe, Alta, Frisco, Deer Rock, Little Rock, Tennessee, Clinton, Dixon, Spear Lake, Bear Lake, Clay Lake, Clear Lake, oh, Ramsey! I've been everywhere in land, I've been everywhere in land. Across the desert there, in land, and I breathe the mountain there, in land. Travel, I've had my share, in land, I've been everywhere.
Now, Cooper and I have been everywhere, as far east as Virginia, west to California, north to Michigan, and south to Louisiana. Now we can add Boise to our list.
I've been everywhere in land, I've been everywhere in land, across the desert there in land, and I breathe the mountain there in land, travel I've had my share in land.
Was there anywhere that you hadn't been?
Well, I've been everywhere. Ha-hee!
Contestants in the interview, swimsuit, and talent competitions, and now the final phase, the stunning evening gown competition. Now back to Patricia.
Thank you so much, and our final competition is now before us. In the evening gown competition, you will see our eight semifinalists in their beautiful gowns. During the competition, each contestant will be judged on poise, appearance, and the ability to carry herself in a natural and confident manner. Ladies and gentlemen, our 1989 Miss Idaho semifinalist in evening gown competition. Beginning with contestant number one, Miss Boise, Melanie Jean Lavoie.
Music has always played a major role in my life. My educational goals are business-oriented. I'm counting on a stable college degree and the business experience I've already attained to help me reach my ultimate goal of becoming a successful recording artist.
Melanie has light brown hair and green eyes. She's 5 feet 5 inches tall. She enjoys skiing and speed walking, among several sports. She has a unique collection of homemade Christmas ornaments. Her previous pageant titles have enabled Miss Boise to travel almost half of the United States as a guest entertainer, production manager, and pageant MC. Contestant number one, Melanie Jean Lavoie, Miss Boise. Contestant number two, Miss Eastern Idaho, Stephanie Ann Smith.
I'm a 1988 graduate from BSU with a degree in marketing. Marketing is made up of four concepts: product, price, place, and promotion. Well, the product is the Miss America pageant, the place, Atlantic City, the promotion, Miss Idaho to become Miss America, and the price, one exciting year of your life. And I would like the opportunity to market Idaho for you.
Stephanie is 5 feet 6.5 inches tall. She has brown hair and blue eyes. She enjoys participating in aerobics and downhill and water skiing. Miss Eastern Idaho is always in demand to play her harp for weddings, receptions, and parties. Stephanie collects silver spoons from throughout the world. Miss Eastern Idaho is a part-time owner of Amco Transmissions and Builders Marketplace Incorporated here in Boise. Contestant number two, Stephanie Ann Smith, Miss Eastern Idaho. Contestant number six, Miss Meridian, Pamela Westover.
Through my involvement in student government at Boise State University, I've become aware of special needs that exist in our area. While serving on committees that address a few of these concerns, I've learned that one person really can make a difference. In the future, I plan to stay active in the community by using my advertising skills and my enthusiasm to promote the activities that will ensure the quality of life we enjoy here in Idaho.
Pamela is 5 feet 7 inches tall. She has blue eyes and blonde hair. Her many hobbies are jogging and fun runs, calligraphy, and volunteerism. She counts jogging, snorkeling, and weightlifting as favorite sports. She's a fourth-generation native Idahoan. Pamela was born on the 179th anniversary of the signing of the Constitution. She also admits that she's a real ice cream fanatic. Contestant number six, Pamela Westover, Miss Meridian. Contestant number eight, Miss Idaho Falls, Darity Lynn Somers.
When I was 5 years old, Santa Claus brought me a small chalkboard for Christmas. And for the next 5 years, I pretended I was a high school history and English teacher. Strangely enough, my goal now is to obtain my bachelor's degree in secondary education, so that I will be able to teach United States history and English literature in the high school systems of Idaho.
With hazel eyes and blonde hair, Darity stands 5 feet 7 inches tall. She participates in water skiing, snow skiing, golf, and jogging, just to name a few. Among her hobbies are reading, ceramics, dancing, and toll painting. The Junior Music Club Young Artist of the Month in April 1988. Darity has taught piano for the last 4 years. Contestant number eight, Darity Lynn Somers, Miss Idaho Falls. Contestant number five, Miss Idaho National Guard, Amy Lynn Kendall.
So many times we hear the question asked, where do you find happiness? And often that answer seems to be, when I make my first million, or when I finally graduate, or when the kids are out of the house. Through my work with young people, many of whom have cancer, I've come to realize that one does not find happiness, one makes it within himself. You can be in the lowest of places, carrying the heaviest of burdens, and still be truly happy. My hope is that I can share the happiness that I have made within myself with others.
Five feet, 8.5 inches tall, with brown hair and brown eyes, Amy enjoys traveling, talking, singing, and working with children. Among her sports interests are racquetball and rappelling. Miss Idaho National Guard has taught modeling and self-esteem courses to young girls. She's also served as a counselor at Camp Rainbow Gold. Contestant number five, Amy Lynn Kendall, Miss Idaho National Guard. Contestant number 12, Miss Rexburg Upper Valley, Raymond Jean Griffith.
My motto in life is, if you can imagine it, you can achieve it. If you can dream it, you can become it. One of my goals is to obtain a secondary education degree in the field of health science and dance.
Raymond Jean is 5 feet 8 inches tall, has auburn hair and dark brown eyes. She likes to spend her free time riding horses, whether that's Roman riding or rodeoing. She also said she likes to dance and go skiing. At Ricks College, she participates in the Rodeo Team Americanas. Miss Rexburg Upper Valley is the youngest of four girls in her family, and yet she said she's the only redhead in the whole bunch. Contestant number 12, Raymond Jean Griffith, Miss Rexburg Upper Valley. Contestant number 14, Miss Pocatello, Alicia Lynn Allman.
Through qualities instilled in me as a child, and with experiences I've had, I've decided to pursue my career in psychology, specializing in logotherapy. With the donation of my father's eyes, two people were able to see the beauty of this world for the first time. I would like to help others find happiness and see the beauty of life through their own eyes.
Alicia's 5'8" tall, has dark brown hair and green eyes. She enjoys softball, tennis, and horseback riding. Among her hobbies are dancing, piano playing, stamp collecting, and reading. Ms. Pocatello has performed on a cruise, and she was the state recipient of a Creative and Performing Arts Award. Contestant number 14, Alicia Lynn Allman, Miss Pocatello. Contestant number 15, Miss Treasure Valley, Rebecca Eileen Trueblood.
I'm a 26-year-old seeking a degree in both communications and behavioral studies. I'm excited about my life, and I believe with all my heart that the only goal that is unattainable is one that we do not reach for.
Becky has green eyes and blonde hair. She stands 5'6" tall. Her hobbies include running, water skiing, and walking along the beach. She also is a participant in many sports, including tennis, racquetball, and volleyball. Miss Treasure Valley has traveled extensively throughout the United States and to over 20 foreign countries as a vocal performer with the Heritage Singers, a professional gospel music group. Contestant number 15, Rebecca Eileen Trueblood, Miss Treasure Valley. Ladies and gentlemen, our 8 semifinalists for the title of Miss Idaho 1989 in Evening Gown Competition.
The competition for tonight's pageant has been completed, and the decision now rests with the judges. I don't envy them a bit. All of the points for each of the finalists will now be tabulated by the firm of Belukoff Lindstrom & Company. Join us in a few moments for the crowning of Miss Idaho 1989 and a welcome to our past Miss Idahos on this, the 40th anniversary celebration. We'll be back right after this message. Tonight, the Miss Idaho pageant celebrates its 40th anniversary. Now, let's see what Patricia and Cooper are up to.
Hey, Trish. What's that, Cooper? How old are you? Now, Cooper, you know better than to ask any woman her age.
I know. I'm just in that old birthday mood.
Well, good for you, because you know it's the 40th anniversary of the Miss Idaho pageant.
40 years old. Woo! Where's the party?
Well, the party's right here. You know what? Behind this curtain, we have some special guests that are going to help us celebrate.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho. I'm Barbara Norton Brown from Burley, Miss Idaho 1950, the first Miss Idaho. I've been married for 38 years to the same man, Paul Brown, a dentist from Burley, and I'm the happy mother of 5 grown children and the grandmother of 10 brilliant, gorgeous grandchildren.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho. I am Phyllis Gokey, Ralston Gokey, 1951. My home is in Richland, Washington, but my heart is in Idaho. I am now in production of Camelot. I've enjoyed many, many productions during the years, and I think I'm almost late for rehearsal right now.
Happy birthday,
I'm Zoanne Warburg Schaub, Miss Idaho of 1952. My birthday greetings come from Twin Falls, where I practiced law, held a judgeship, and am now enjoying the best part of my life, my family.
Hi. I'm Linda Moulton Howe, born and raised in Boise, Miss Idaho, 1963. Since then, I've traveled throughout the world as a producer, writer, director, and editor of documentary films. Now I have a production company in Denver, have a wonderful daughter, and have written a new book entitled An Alien Harvest, about alien life forms intruding on this planet. I have always been grateful for participating in these pageants and wish a heartfelt happy birthday, Miss Idaho.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho pageant. I'm Irene Ammons Link, Miss Idaho 1962. I live in Salt Lake City, where I'm a consultant in public relations and communications training. I'm very grateful for what the Miss Idaho pageant allowed me to do with my life. Thank you.
Happy anniversary, Miss Idaho, and greetings from Oklahoma City. I'm Laverta Garrison Jacobs, Miss Idaho 1961. I'm the mother of six children, so I just like to refer to myself as a domestic goddess.
Hi, I'm Karen Ryder Livingston. I was Miss Idaho in 1968. I am currently living in Weezer, Idaho with my really good-looking son, 15-year-old Ryan, and I'm working with my father at Ryder Ford Sales in Weezer, Idaho, and I'm trying to decide what I'm going to do when I grow up, so I'm going back to school and I'm majoring in forestry.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho. I'm Diana Hopperstad Titus. My husband Ron and I reside in Sacramento, California, where I continue a career in as a professional entertainer and musician of country music and gospel music. And I was Miss Twin Falls of 1968 and Miss Idaho 1969. Happy birthday and God bless you, Miss Idaho.
Good evening. I'm Karen Hurd Talbot. I was Miss Idaho of 1971. Went on to become first runner-up to Miss America in 1972. I'm currently living in Salt Lake City with my husband Jim Talbot, who incidentally is from Boise. We have four children, two girls and two boys. Happy birthday, Miss Idaho. We love you. It's good to be back.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho. And welcome to my hometown. I'm Vicki Hawkins Keebler, Miss Idaho of 1972. I work full-time at the Board of Accountancy, and my husband Joe and I are the proud parents of our 9-year-old daughter, Gentry. Happy birthday.
Hi, I'm Sharon Davis Meeks, Miss Idaho 1973. I am leading what I consider to be the ideal Idaho lifestyle. My husband, Jim, is a third-generation farmer in Jerome. I teach business courses at Twin Falls High School, and we are raising two lovely daughters. Happy anniversary, Miss Idaho Pageant.
Happy anniversary, Miss Idaho Pageant. My name is Renee Peterson McKee, and I was Miss Idaho 1976 and a Talent Award winner at the Miss America Pageant. I am currently the happy mother of five children, a music teacher, and the director for the Center for Leadership in Pocatello.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho. I'm Leslie Taylor Joyce. I was Miss Idaho in 1980. I am here as living, breathing proof that Miss Idahos are well-rounded people. I'm the mother of two children, 2 3/4, and I'm pleased to be here. I live in Salt Lake City with my husband, who's an attorney. I teach school, I teach special education, as well as piano lessons. Happy birthday, Miss Idaho.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho.
I'm Elaine Pack-Litster. I was Miss Idaho in 1983, and as a harpist, I was a talent award winner at the Miss America pageant in 1984. I'm currently living in Los Angeles, where I'm working on a master's degree in urban planning at UCLA, and probably the best thing in my life is my wonderful husband of 1 year.
I'm Patty Hogue Cox, Miss Idaho 1984. My husband and I would like to share with you tonight another special birthday, and that's the daughter, our firstborn, who's 1 week old tonight. And from Mom and Dad, happy birthday, Courtney, and happy birthday, Miss Idaho.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho pageant. I'm Nanette South Larson, Miss Idaho 1985. I currently live in Manan, where I operate a finishing school for junior high and high school students. I am married to a wonderful man, Doug, and I have a 1-year-old boy, Matthew.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho. I'm Jennifer Hubby Faylash. I currently live in Boise with my brand new husband, Michael, whom I married in December.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho, from your youngest and newest contestant, member, Susan K. Hart, Miss Idaho 1988. And Cooper, we're happy you're here tonight, too. Thank you.
Woo, Susan, it's great to be here. You know, all of these are Miss Idaho's. They sure were, Cooper. Each one of these women has had the opportunity to walk that long runway in Atlantic City, but representing the great state of Idaho. I got an idea of something you can do for them. You gonna do it?
Hit it, girl. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Miss Idaho. It's been a great 40 years. In a few moments, the 40th Miss Idaho will be crowned at the Morrison Center stage. Stay with us. Welcome back to the 40th annual Miss Idaho Scholarship Pageant. We're coming to you live from the Morrison Center. Now back to your host, Patricia Brandt Tozen.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome the beautiful Susan K. Hart, Miss Idaho 1988, in her farewell walk. Okay, it looks like we're looking for her right now. She doesn't want to give up the crown. That's it. She's left. She's decided she's not going to give up the crown. I just want to say what a pleasure it has been to be here in Idaho. Like the little song said that Cooper and I did, I thought I had been everywhere, but I had not been to Idaho. And so it's been such a pleasure to be here. And I know how proud you must have been of Susan, because it is tough to be a state queen. And here she is. Please welcome for her farewell walk, Miss Susan K. Hart.
Few things can equal the excitement I felt as I was crowned Miss Idaho 1988. This past year was the most demanding and rewarding experience in my life. It is not without sadness that I leave this never-forgotten year behind. This pageant has opened the door to many new horizons and personal growth. With each coming day and event, I met wonderful people and made everlasting memories. I would like to thank the Miss Idaho Scholarship Pageant Board members for all of their time and energy devoted to this pageant. I would also like to thank those members who gave up their time to travel with me and help me prepare for Atlantic City, as well as the many people who did travel back to the Miss America pageant and cheer me on. Your cards, gifts, and good looks are greatly appreciated. A large thanks to Tom and Leanne Ambrose, who were my host family and took me in as one of their own children. Thank you, Leanne, for all of your support, time, energy, and enthusiasm put forth in my behalf. I feel very fortunate to have lived with such a wonderful family and share experiences together. I'm very grateful for them and to Eric, Amy, and little Eric, their children. I know none of this would have been possible were it not for my parents and family. They were always there for me in any way possible. I owe them a great deal for the sacrifices made in my behalf. I could not ask for a more supportive family. And I'm also very grateful for the generosity of the many sponsors. Without state and community sponsorship, it would be extremely difficult for Miss Idaho and local Queens. Thank you to the Boise Host Lions Club. I could go on forever thanking the people who were there for me and the numerous sponsors who provide the means for Miss Idaho. This past year has made a great impact on my life and the many opportunities provided and the people I associated with. As I crown the next Miss Idaho, another chapter in my life unfolds, with the past year's experiences as a tool for writing. One goal is completed and many still lie ahead.
And won't you please help me welcome back to the stage our 15 beautiful contestants. Privilege to present the new Quality of Life Scholarship Award brought to us by Fruit of the Loom, a major sponsor of the Miss America pageant. The Fruit of the Loom Quality of Life Award will be presented to one winner from each state, as well as a winner from the national pageant in Atlantic City. These women have been selected because they have made a significant contribution to improving the quality of life in their community through involvement through civic or charitable projects. Miss Idaho 1988 will be presenting a $500 scholarship check on behalf of Fruit of the Loom to Miss Amy Lynn Kendall, Miss Idaho National Guard.
It's only a matter of minutes now, and a new Miss Idaho will be crowned, so don't go away. It's been a pleasure to bring you this live telecast of the 40th annual Miss Idaho Scholarship Pageant. And now back to the Morrison Center stage for the announcement of the Court of Honor and the coronation of the new Miss Idaho.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Miss America national sponsor, Sheer Indulgence Hosiery, I'd like to announce that tonight's winner will receive a $1,000 scholarship. The Sheer Indulgence Confidence Scholarship will be awarded to each of the 51 state winners, recognizing that successful women like Miss Idaho pursue their goals with confidence. Congratulations from Sheer Indulgence. Each contestant will have many memories to cherish from this experience in Boise at the 1989 Miss Idaho pageant, but only one of them will have the opportunity this year to become Miss America 1990. Who will she be? May I have the envelope, please? Ladies and gentlemen, the fourth runner-up to Miss Idaho 1989 and the winner of a $550 scholarship is Darity Lynn Somers, Miss Idaho Falls. And the third runner-up to Miss Idaho 1989 and the winner of a $650 scholarship is Amy Lynn Kendall, Miss Idaho National Guard. The second runner-up to Miss Idaho 1989 and the winner of a $750 scholarship is Rayma Jean Griffith, Miss Rexburg Upper Valley. The position of first runner-up, of course, is very important because if for any reason Miss Idaho 1989 cannot fulfill her duties in the year ahead, our first runner-up will be given the title of Miss Idaho 1989. The first runner-up to Miss Idaho 1989 and the winner of a $1,000 scholarship is Melanie Jean Lavoie, Miss Boise. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of over $5,000 in scholarships and the crown of Miss Idaho 1989, Rebecca Eileen Trugler.
On television have seen me all evening, but I had to come out and prove to you that I really haven't been standing back there with my pajamas on. And here she is, the new Miss Idaho. So we'd like to ask you. We would like to ask you a few questions here on this, your big night here. First of all, I'm sure you've imagined this a million times. How does it feel in real life?
I don't really think there are actual words to express how this feels. You know, on TV, you see that Miss America is how they just break out crying and you think that's probably just a joke. Believe me, it is not a joke. It really happens. It's wonderful. I'm very, very excited. And thank you so much, judges. Thank you.
Now, I've been talking with some people backstage, and they've told me what a change you're in for this next year. Are you prepared for that? Do you know what's going to happen?
I don't really know what is ahead, but I'm very excited for the challenge, and I'm going to give it my very best.
Say, what is the funniest thing? What is the funniest thing that has happened to you during this week of the pageant? I understand there's been plenty of funny moments. What was your funniest moment?
Well, actually, it just happened before the evening gown. I was the last person behind the stage after my talent, and as I was walking on the stage, I realized I had a run in my pantyhose, and so I had to change those, and I was back there, and as I was behind stage, I heard them calling evening gown, so I had to run in my evening gown all the way out here, and I pretty much tripped up the stairs.
So I'm sure you didn't think that was real funny at the moment.
No, but I can laugh about it now.
Now, the emphasis on this pageant is the scholarship that it offers. When you're done with your year of commitment with the pageant, what do you plan to do now that this opportunity has been opened up to you?
Well, I have about a year and a half left of school. I'm a communications and behavioral studies major, and I plan on using my scholarship for that.
All right. Wonderful. Congratulations. Since it is the 40th anniversary of the Miss Idaho pageant, we thought it would be fun to come out and talk with the first Miss Idaho. Here she comes. Hi. Now, I'm sure this pageant has changed a whole lot since you came out on this stage. What are some of the changes that are most notable to you?
First of all, the fact that it's being held inside because we were outdoors in a baseball diamond the first year. And I remember distinctly that I hit a very high note on my song and one of the huge floodlights exploded. So I remember that.
That's happened to me on TV before.
I have been so impressed. I've come back maybe every 3 or 4 years. And I am just absolutely flabbergasted at the professional staging, the beautiful gowns, the quality of the talent, the Boise Lions Club. I'm afraid you just don't appreciate what they do every year. This is wonderful.
It is wonderful.
Yes.
Now, even though the pageant has changed quite a bit, I'm sure there are some words of wisdom that you can offer the new Miss Idaho.
I guess the best thing I can tell her is to have a wonderful year. I don't think that there's anything that replaces genuine kindness, love, spontaneity, and your new Miss Idaho seems to have all of that. I think she's going to be a knockout back east. Yeah!
Thank you so much. Well, let's go back to the stage. As you know, I feel a little inferior, not only because I'm down here on the bottom step, but these girls are absolutely fabulous. And I heard some of them talking earlier today that it's been a wonderful experience for all of them, and they were all very deserving of it. Why don't you tell us what you thought about your competition? It was tough, wasn't it?
Oh, it was extremely tough. I think from the very beginning, everyone was so good. The talent was so good. The performance, but you know, the neatest thing, and I have to say this, is every one of these girls are beautiful people inside. And it has been the neatest experience for me because there has not been one problem with personalities. All those horror stories you hear about pageants, that has not been that way at all. It's been wonderful. And each one of these girls deserved to wear this crown just as much as I did.
All right. Wonderful. I see a lot of tears up here. Are these tears of happiness? What do you feel about now?
I think that most of all, they're tears of relief. It's just a letdown that, you know, of all the tension that has built up during the past week.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything that you'd like to say in the final moments of the pageant?
I would just like to thank all the people that has helped me get ready for this, and I am very happy that Becky won it.
Miss Boise, any final words through those tears?
Well, I'd like to welcome you all here. And thank you all for coming. I'd like to thank especially my family. They flew all the way in from Massachusetts for this. And thank you, judges. It's been a wonderful experience.
And how about you?
I'd like to thank all my parents, the committee, for being here. And I just want to tell you that Becky and I were roommates this week, and she's a lovely, lovely person, and I'm so excited for her.
There they are. All all the wonderful contestants in 1989, a year to remember, the 40th anniversary. Thank you so much for joining us here, and you folks at home, good night.
Well, a new Miss Idaho has been crowned, and we sincerely hope that you've enjoyed our 40th anniversary pageant. A special thanks to KIVI Channel 6 and all our sponsors for bringing our pageant to you. Thank you, all of you former Miss Idahos, Susan K. Hart, Miss Idaho 1988, Dwayne Lewis Kemp for his music, my special friends, Cooper, Katie, and Gumbo, and the hundreds of people who have made this year's pageant possible. This is Patricia Brandt-Tosen on behalf of all of us at the Miss Idaho pageant saying good night, and thank you for joining us.